Learning how to duck dive. This is a fundamental part of surfing, and it's also a make or break. So there's a couple ways you can duck dive when you're paddling out. You're going to need to duck dive because there's always going to be foamies coming at you unless you're really lucky and you can jump off the back of a boat. And even then, you're going to have a wave, you're going to come in, you're going to get stuck. So there's two ways of doing it. Obviously, at the moment, you're learning with a longer board, so it's quite difficult to duck dive the conventional way. So you can either learn how to turtle roll, which I'm going to show you in this video, or learn how to let go of your board in a safe place where it's not going to hurt anybody else and it's not going to hurt you. One of the key things that you need to do is not hold onto your fin. Your fins on your board are very sharp. So if you turn your board over and you're gripping on here and the wave catches you, you're going to slice your hand open. The other thing is to not hold onto your leash too close because it's also going to bang your hand on the back of your board. So the best thing to do is to either hold onto your rail and try. If it's really small, I wouldn't suggest doing this when it gets a bit bigger because same thing, it's going to yank your arm out. And obviously this board's quite small. When you've got a long board and it's pulling on your shoulder, you're going to hurt your shoulder. So the best thing to do if you don't want to turtle roll is the wave's coming at you, you've got plenty of time, you know it's breaking. Turn your board over so your fins are facing up. Make sure your leash is nicely ahead of you in a nice straight line. Make sure there's nobody behind you, first of all. And then swim under the wave, count to 2 seconds, and if it's shallow enough, you can go to the bottom and you can push up off the sand. You know that your board's going to be behind you, so you're not going to come up, it's not going to hit you on the head. You come up, and your board's either going to be still face down, or it's going to be flipped over. So if it's flipped over, you're lucky, it's going to pull towards you nicely. If it's face down, you're going to struggle a bit. You're going to have to pull on the cord a little bit more. Pull the cord in, get your board, get on your board again, start paddling. Okay, now this way gets quite tiring because then if there's another wave, you're going to have to do the same thing. So if you feel there's 3 waves coming in a row, you've let your board go, you've ducked under it, you've pulled it in, maybe try and hold it close to you so you can hold onto the leash or try and hold onto the tail. And if the wave's a bit smaller, you can hold onto the back of your board or the leash from a distance. Make sure you're not too close, it's going to bang your knuckles on the board. Or if it's another big wave, keep it close, same thing, duck under, come up, pull it in again. Once the waves have gone, grab your board, get on as quick as you can, and start paddling out as fast as you can again. I know you guys are tired, but this is your break in the sets. So the most tiring thing is going under, coming up, going under, coming up. So once the waves have gone, don't waste any time. On your board, paddle as hard as you can. Rather get to backline where it's safe, then you can rest for as long as you need to. But that in between, in the mid-break there where the waves are, that's what's going to tire you out. Right, if you're willing to try, you can try a turtle roll. So a little bit more tricky. As the wave's coming, you're going to give yourself a bit of time. You're going to hold onto the rails of the board. You're going to put your foot on the back tail, and you're going to roll over. So the board is on top of you and you are underneath the water. As the wave hits you, you're going to do a breaststroke kick with your legs and you're going to push your board away from you and it's going to push you up to the surface. Yes, it is going to throw you around a bit, but you're going to have your board with you by the time you come up. So you're going to kick your legs in a breaststroke kick, you're going to push your board away from you, and your board, as the wave goes past, you're going to turn over and you're going to paddle on your board back out again. So you turtle draw back over. Same thing, next wave comes, wait for it to come. Make sure you don't go too late. You don't want to be turtle rolling as that foam is hitting you, because then you are going to get wiped out. Make sure you have enough time to turtle roll over, have a nice breath, push away off the foamy, kick breaststroke legs, and push through. And then you're off, up and away. If you like this video, hit the like button, subscribe to our channel, and we'll see you in the next video.